Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Suppose you lose all your important files, photos, or even your entire system because of a crash. Scary, right? That's why backup are so important. In today's video, I will show you a tool that can help you with system backup, file backup, disk backup, and even cloning your system or hard drive to protect your data. It's easy, reliable, and perfect for beginners. So let's check out this tool and explore all the features it has. The tool I am going to explore today is Aomei Backupper. It is a reliable Windows backup software designed to safeguard your operating system, data, and application using its backup, restore, or clone features. Whether you need to backup your files, protect your system, or clone your disk, Aomei helps you to do it easily. I have put the link in the description below. Once you are on the page, simply click on the download to get started. Once you are on the page, you will see different download options for Windows PC. There is a standard version which is free, and then there are options for professional and workstation version. This paid version comes with 30-day free trial. You can use them for 30 days, and if you think they are worth it, you can purchase them. Otherwise, you can stick with the standard version for free. But for this video, I will go with the professional version. So I will click on free trial. The file is only 138 MB, so it will download quickly. Once the download is complete, double-click the installer. A window will pop up asking for select the setup language. Just click OK. Then click Install Now. The installation takes only a couple of seconds. Once the installation is complete, you can close the window and you are all set to start using Aomei Backupper. Now double-click on the desktop icon to open the tool. Once it opens, you will see a clean and easy to navigate dashboard. On the left hand side, there is a pane with all the main options: backup, sync, restore, clone, and tools. So let's start with the backup sections. When you click on it, you will see a multiple backup options. You will get system backup. This creates a full backup of your operating system so that you can restore it if anything goes wrong. Okay. And there is an option called disk backup. This backup your entire hard disk, including all partition and data. And in partition backup, this focuses on backing up specific partition instead of the whole disk. And in file backup, this lets you backup individual files or folder, perfect for saving important documents or photos. Okay. And in email backup, you can backup email to keep your important communications secure. Outlook backup is specially designed to backup Microsoft Outlook data like email, contact, and calendar. And in cloud backup, allow you to backup your data directly to the cloud for easy access and extra safety. Now, I am going to backup my system. So, once you open, you will see all your drives listed clearly. Okay. And if I open this PC, you will notice my system drive is C drive. And I also have a D drive which is empty and will be used to store the backup. Okay. To start, select the drive where you want to save the backup. In my case, there's the D drive. After specifying the location, click on Start Backup. The backup process will begin immediately. It might take a few minutes depending on the size of your data. While the backup is running, you can click on Backing Up Data to see details like the transfer speed, remaining time, and others. Okay. For this video, I will first forward this process. Once the backup is complete, you will see a message saying the current operation has been completed. Simply click on Finish to wrap it up. After the backup is done, you will find the backup file saved on your specified drive. If I check my D drive, you can see the system backup file is right here. If you ever want to delete the backup, it's very easy. Just go back to the Aomei Backupper, locate the backup, click on the three vertical dots next to it, and select Delete from the list. Confirm by clicking OK, and the backup file will be removed from your drive. Now, I will show you how you can backup your important files. It's super easy to do, okay? So, select the file backup options on the main screen. Click on Add Folder to choose the folder or files you want to backup. This is where you can select the data you want to protect, okay? Now, next, select the destination drive where you want to save the backup file. This could be an external drive, a different partition, or even a network location. Okay. Below, you will find the schedule backup options. Here you can schedule backup to run daily, weekly, or monthly. So you don't have to remember to do it manually. Okay. Another important option is the backup scheme. And here you will get full backup, incremental backup, and differential backup. Full backup means this creates a complete backup of all your files every time, but it takes the most time and space. Okay. And in incremental backup, saves only the changes made since the last backup, saving time and space. And in differential backup, this backup all changes made since the last full backup, offering a balance between time and storage. Once you have set everything up, click Start Backup. The backup process will begin immediately. It might take a few minutes depending on the size of your files. Okay. When the backup is complete, click Finish, and you will find the backup file saved and listed in the interface. If you no longer need the backup, you can easily delete it from the same interface. Now, let's explore some other features. If you go to the sync sections, you will see options like basic sync, real-time sync, mirrored sync, and two-way sync that can help you keep your files or folder the same across different locations. Now let's move to the clone sections. And here you will find three options: system clone, disk clone, and partition clone. In system clone, these options allow you to clone your entire operating system to another drive. It is perfect if you are upgrading to an SSD or want to backup of your system that's ready to boot. And in disk clone, with these features, you can copy an entire hard drive, including all partition and data, to another drive. It's great for migrating data or creating a duplicate of your disk. Okay. Partition clone. This lets you clone a specific partition instead of the entire disk. It's useful if you want to backup or move just a particular section of your drive. Now let's take a look at the tool section in Aomei Backupper. Here you'll find a variety of custom tools that can make managing your system even easier. And here you will get Create Bootable Media. This tool lets you create a bootable device for both Windows and Linux. It's useful for system recover or when your PC won't boot. Disk Wipe. This feature gives you two options for wiping data. You can either wipe a specific partition or unallocated space on the disk, or you can wipe the entire disk. If you scroll down further, you will find even more free and useful tools like Data Partition Manager. If you click on this option, it will redirect you to the download page where you can get the free version of their partition management tool. iPhone Backup and Transfer. This lets you backup and transfer iPhone data easily, and it's also available for free download. And you will get Any Viewer. This is their free remote desktop application, allowing you to remotely access and control other computers. Okay. And you will also get My Recover Apps. This data recovery tool is designed to help you recover deleted documents, photos, videos, emails, and even data from formatted or lost partition. Okay. So this is a fantastic tool for anyone looking to protect their data. It's a beginner friendly, packed with useful features, and even offered a free version to get started. After using the free trial for 30 days, you can upgrade to a paid version, which offers flexible options like Pro Yearly, Pro Lifetime, and even a Family Lifetime plan for multiple users. So that's it for today's review, guys. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more tech tutorials, and let me know in the comments if you have any questions. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.